Hello dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you. Okay, so as we know, we are discussing about our first lesson, that is sources of food. And in that sources of the food, today we will see the next point, that is what animals eat. Up till now we have discussed that food from plant, we have discussed food from animals, and now today we will discuss the next point, that is what animals eat. So if you are having pet at home, or you have observed the what is the food for that pet, you are feeding them with the milk, sometimes you are giving them chapati, also you are giving some biscuits to them, also sometimes you are giving some meat to them. Okay, so there are the different types of the food we are giving to our pets. So in our environment, in our nature, there are the different animals, and the different animals are having different food habits. Okay, food habits means what? Each and every animals don't have the same food habits. There are the certain animals, those who are eating only plants, while there are the certain animals, those who are not eating the plants, instead of the plants they are eating the flesh of other animals. Okay, and there are the certain animals on the earth, there are the certain organisms on the earth, those who are eating the plant products also, and so they are eating the flesh of animals also. Okay, so on the basis of the what animals eat, what are their food habits, the animals are classified, or the animals are divided into the three groups, and which are the groups today we will discuss. So on the basis of the food habits of the animals are classified into the three groups, and the groups are herbivores, carnivores and omnivores. So one by one we will discuss about all these different groups. So first one we will discuss about herbivores. So what is meant by herbivores? Herbivores are the animals, those who are eating the plants or plants product. Means the animal, those who are eating only green plants, that animals are called as herbivores or herbivorous animals. Okay, there are so many examples of the herbivorous animal. For example, we can say that cows, goats, rabbit, sheep, deer, zebra, giraffe, all these are the animals, those who are eating the plants. Okay, means instead of the plant they are not eating anything, they are just eating the green plants or the green grass. Okay, so they are eating only the plants or plants products, and the animal, those who are eating the plants or the plant products, are called as what? Herbivores, or it is also called as what? Herbivorous animals. Examples also we have discussed, examples are cows, goat, rabbit, sheep and deer. Now we'll move for the next group or the next classification, that is carnivores. What is mean by carnivores? So there are the certain animals, those who are eating the flesh of other animals, means they are killing the animals and they are eating the flesh of the animals. So, and the organisms or the animals, those who are eating the flesh of other animals, that animals are called as carnivores. Okay, that animals are called as carnivores or carnivorous. Okay, and there are so many examples of the carnivores also. We can say the lions are there, tigers are there, eagles are there. There are so many other animals, those who are carnivores. Okay, panther is there, the panther also comes into the carnivores or carnivorous category. So what is mean by carnivores? Carnivores means what? The animals, those who are eating the flesh of other animals, that animals are called as carnivorous. They are killing the animals and they are eating the flesh of that animals, that animals are called carnivores or carnivorous. Now we'll move for the next category of the animals, that is omnivores. Now what is mean by omnivores? So there are the certain organisms, there are the certain animals, those who are eating the plants product also and eating the animals flesh also, and combined means they are doing the combination of that. Sometimes they are eating the plant product, sometimes they are eating the flesh of the animals. So the organisms or the animals, those who are eating the plants and the flesh of other animals, that category of the animals is called as what? Omnivores or omnivorous. Okay, and the examples of omnivores are very well known, that all the human beings comes under what? Omnivores. Next one is what? Bears, rat, crows and cockroaches. All these are the examples of what? Carnivorous all these are the examples of omnivores animals. Okay, so these are the three categories that based on the food habits of animals. What is in the herbivores? Animals, those who are eating the grass or the green plants product, are called as what? Herbivores. Next one is the animals, those who are killing the animals and eating the flesh of other animals, that animals are called as carnivores or carnivorous. Next one is the animals, those who are eating the plants also and the flesh of other animals also, that organisms are called as omnivores or omnivorous. So these are the three categories which is based on the food habits of an animals. But the next point is that there are the certain animals, those animals are not killing the other animals, but still they are eating the flesh of that animals. Okay, so there are the certain animals, those who are eating the flesh of dead and decaying animals, or they are eating the flesh of animals which are not killed by themselves. Okay, which are not killed by themselves. Whatever the remaining flesh is there or decaying flesh is there, they are eating that flesh, and that category of the animals are called as what? Scavengers. So the scavenger means what? The scavengers are the animals, those who are eating the remaining flesh or the dead and decaying flesh of an organisms, that animals are called as scavengers. Or in the easy language we can say that the animals, those who are eating the flesh of other animals, but that organisms or that animal is not killed by themselves. Whatever the leftover flesh is there, they are eating that, and that category of an animals, it is called as what? Scavengers. Okay, what are the examples of scavenger? We can say that jackals are there, hyenas are there, and vultures also comes into the scavenger. So the scavenger is also the one group of an animals which is based on the food habit. Now the next one is there, which is very important, and that is what? Decomposers. Okay, that is called as what? Decomposers. So there are the certain living organisms, for example we can say that fungi and bacteria. There are the certain fungi and the bacteria which are eating the dead and decaying flesh or the dead and decaying bodies of an animals. Okay, and that's why they are called as what? Decomposers. Now decomposers means what? What they are doing? They are feeding on the dead and decaying matters. Okay, they are feed on the dead plants or animal materials, and they helps to clean the our environment. They are feeding on the dead and decaying matter or the material of an material which is getting from the plants or the animals, means some parts of animal or some time what happen, the animals get dead and it remains as it is on the land. But after some times we can say, or after some days we can say that animals is not there. Okay, where it goes, or some parts of the plant get mixed into the soil. How they get mixed into the soil? Because of some decomposers. And which are the decomposers? Fungi and bacteria. These are the decomposers. Decomposers means what? Those who are feeding on the dead and decaying material of plants and animals. Okay, means what is their work? They are vanishing that dead and decaying material from the environment. That's why scavenger and decomposers are called as, or they help to clean our nature. They are called as natural cleaner. Natural cleaner means what? They are scavengers are eating the leftover flesh. These decomposers are feeding on the dead and decaying material. So in this way, what they are doing? They are vanishing. They are destroying all that dead and decaying matter from the earth. That's why they are called as cleaner of the earth, or they are cleaning our earth. They helps to clean our earth. Okay, so in this way, these scavengers and decomposers are also very useful for us. Next one. Here we are talking about the fungi. So sometimes you are eating the fungi also. Have you know mushrooms? Yes, the mushroom is also the one of the example of fungi. Mushroom is not a plant product, or it is not the animal product also. The mushroom is goes under the fungi category, and the fungi is itself, it is a separate category. Okay, it is not a plant also, and it is not an animal also. So there are the certain fungi which are edible, and there are the certain fungi which are poisonous too. Okay, so in this way, these fungi helps to decompose also, and there some fungi we are eating also. So in this way, on the basis of the food habits, the animals are divided into three parts, that are herbivores, carnivores, omnivores, and also we can see that also we are having scavengers and decomposers on our earth, which helps to clean the earth. So this is all about today. Today I'll end my lesson. Next point will continue in the next lecture. For today, thank you.